They say that the way you do some things is the way you do everything. So it is important that we keep our surroundings and our house clutter-free, organized, and beautiful, because it has a direct impact not just on our health, happiness, mood, and stress levels, but also on our mind. So I am Abhilasha Mehta. I am mommy to two young children. I'm the wife of an amazing entrepreneur. I am the founder, director, CEO, everything rolled into one for my brand, Ek Dori, and I am a YouTuber. Today we are talking about 5 simple tips to keep your home organized, clutter-free, and clean. There was a study, and in that study, they said that 90% people said that a cluttered environment affects them in a negative manner. We are going to change all of that and make sure that with these 5 tips, your house is always organized and clean. My tip number 1 is the basic of organization. It is the foundation. If you get that right, your entire organization effort will be built on a beautiful foundation. Everything in your house and everything in your space has a home, whether it is a small key, a small screw, a pencil, an eraser. Every little thing must have a home, and if you can put the name of that thing on top of the home, then it makes it even more easier for your entire family, friends, and the entire house to help you keep your home organized and clutter-free. Making a home for every little thing helps in another way, and that is that when you need those small little things in your life, you will not end up spending 2 hours looking for those things and tearing your entire house down looking for a screw. So when everything has a home, you know exactly where to go, pick it up, use it, put it back, and you save so much time. These homes can be very, very creative. You can use boxes, you can use baskets, you can use a host of different creative things to make homes for all the tiny and the big things in your house. For example, I am a lover of coffee, and whenever I get my brand of coffee on discount, I tend to buy it and keep it safe. But these coffee jars need a home, and I use this beautiful little box from Westside, and I keep all my coffee jars in it, and when I need it, I know exactly where to get it, I know where to put it back, and my space looks beautiful and clutter-free as well. So that brings me to my tip number 2. All the things in your house that you haven't been able to create a home for, where do they end up? They all end up on surfaces in your house. So they'll end up on the bed, on the sofa, on the floor, on the table. So wherever there's a flat surface, that is where all those things will end up. When you look around at any space, the first thing you see is the surfaces. And if those surfaces are filled with clutter and filled with a lot of things, it just makes the mind go crazy. It makes the space look really cluttered. And if you want to have a clutter-free home, the first things to clean are the surfaces. Make a home for all of those things and just dump them there. If there are a lot of papers lying on the table, just gather all of them, create a drawer or a home for those papers and just dump them there, okay? First thing is to just create a home and clear your surfaces. Once your surfaces are clear and clean, it just brings a sense of calm on my mind. So once you're calm and composed, and once you have a little more time, then you pull out the drawer full of papers and clean up the papers, get rid of what you don't need, file what you need, and organize the drawer and close it. So first thing is immediately clean up all the surfaces, and then when you have more time, go one space at a time and then do a deep clean, so that you're not piling on too much work on yourself. My tip number 3 is something that I have learned very, very recently. All along, I have been trained to believe that when you have cupboards and when you have proper storage and all of that, then your home looks clutter-free and organized, which I completely agree with, okay? So create your cupboards, create your storage units, create your baskets, whatever storage space you can create for yourself, create that. But don't keep building, and don't keep buying more cupboards, and don't keep buying more storage units. Make something, decide that this is enough space for me and my life, and this is what I'm going to use. Because I have seen, when you feel like you need a new cupboard, you buy it, you fill it up, It looks neat and organized for a month, but then the next month or after 6 months, again, it will be filled and you will think, oh, I need another cupboard. If only I had another cupboard. You get that. And then same thing keeps repeating till your house is overflowing all over again. So buying new cupboards and creating more storage space is not the solution. What you have to do is just the reverse, and you have to say that, okay, I'm going to buy only as much stuff as I can fit in my house, in my cupboards, in a neat and uncluttered manner. If I am going beyond that, if I'm feeling like I need a new cupboard or I need more in storage in my life, it just means that I have too much stuff and I need to get rid of that stuff. I have seen people who have rooms full of just cupboards, an entire room which is just cupboards, and initially it looks perfect, and then it starts to overflow and goes into other rooms, and then it overflows and goes out of the house. And then you reach a point where nothing is enough and you just need to keep creating more and more. Don't create more storage. Get rid of some of the stuff that you have. Unless, of course, you've just had a baby or a new member in the family, or, you know, those circumstances, of course, you create more space or create more cupboards. But otherwise, I would say create something and then say, that's it. If it's not fitting here, that just means I need to downsize. To make organization, decluttering, cleaning your house a part of your daily routine. So every morning, as soon as you wake up and get out of bed, make your bed, because that really changes and that really starts off the day also on a very positive way. You get one tick mark on your checklist early in the morning, and then that sets the mood and the pace for the rest of the day. And then at night, part of your cleaning routine should be to clean all the counters of your kitchen so that there are no cockroaches and no pests. During the day, whenever you get 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or a weekly routine where you block a certain amount of time to clean a certain area of your home, whatever's bothering you the most. You know, for me, clutter usually collects on top of my study table. So every few days I will say, okay, I'm going to take 10 minutes and just clear this clutter out. Or it could be your wardrobe. Every few months my wardrobe starts to, you know, explode, literally. Like I open it and things will come out. So, you know, I then know that I need to take care of the wardrobe. So whatever it is, if you build it into your routine that this area, this little space, it does not take too much time, especially if you've already created a home for all of your things. Like my makeup, once I'm done using it, I just know I can just, you know, it takes literally 2 minutes for me to put everything back. Also, if you can get into a habit of putting things back the moment you're done using them, then that clutter doesn't tend to build up. My last and final tip is this, that you could watch 100 videos on organization and cleaning, and you should watch them, especially mine, but it will not happen magically. It will not happen unless you get rid of some of the things in your life. No matter how many clever storage tricks you start using, but if you are the kind who finds it difficult to give things away and get rid of things, then eventually the clutter is going to build up. So don't let that happen to yourself. Don't keep things because you think you might use them some 10 years down the line. Do not keep things out of guilt. I can't tell you how many times I have bought a thing and then I know that I will not end up using it, but I still just keep it because I feel guilty that I've spent money on it and I'm not using it. So just keep it. And then it reaches a stage where the kapda is tearing, things are coming off. I have not used it. I've not let anyone else use it. And eventually it just goes completely waste. So don't do that. Marie Kondo says that if something is not bringing you joy or making you happy, learn to give it away. Say thank you to it for serving you and then give it away to someone who will enjoy it a lot more than you. And I have seen in my life that the more you give, the more you get back. So don't hesitate to give things away. You will enjoy a clutter-free space and a clutter-free home around you, and it'll be like happiness all around. So these were my 5 really basic, you know, they're literally the groundwork of keeping an organized home. So if you follow these 5 tips, then you can build on these with more and more things that you can keep learning. And But these five things are really basic. So start with these five things. And I hope you learned something from this video. I hope you had fun watching this video. If you did, give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe, hit the notification bell. Leave me a comment telling me whether you want to see more home organization kind of videos. We'll of course keep building up now on these five tips. I will see you very soon in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you for watching.